Hello everyone, welcome to Students Point. This is 2nd of March and we will see all the important questions of the day. First, let us see question of the day which you have to answer in the comment section. Here is the question. The first Krishi Vigyan Kendra was established in? These are the options. Read the options and then answer it. And if you wish to get PDF of all these videos, you have to write Students Point 2020 on your Telegram app. You will be referred to our channel and you can get PDF of all these videos. Let's begin. The first question. The Land Records and Services Index 2020 is released by? So it is released by National Council of Applied Economic Research, that is NCAER. This index assesses extent of digitization of land records and the quality of these land records in the states and UTs of India. So it has two components. The first component is about digitization of land record and the second is about quality of these land records. And this LRSI is an integral part of NCAER land policy initiative. This land policy initiative was launched in 2019 and NCAER is part of Property Rights Research Consortium, which is a multi-institutional research consortium. It will collect data of land records in India, which will help in policy formulation. Next question. Yard 45006 Vajra ship is used by? It will be used by Indian Coast Guards, that is ICGs. It is the sixth offshore patrol vessel built by Larsen & Toubro Shipbuilding under Make in India policy to enhance coastal security. Larsen & Toubro will build 7 such offshore patrol vessels, out of which 6 has already been built and 1 more is left. And these offshore patrol vessels are long range surface ships capable of coastal and offshore patrolling, policing marine zones, as well as control and surveillance, anti-smuggling and anti-piracy operations. However, they can also be engaged in limited warfare roles only, not in full-fledged war. Next question. Consider the following statements about Giant Metro Wave Radio Telescope, that is GMRT. GMRT is an array of 30 fully steerable parabolic radio telescope. So focus here, this word is very important. Parabolic radio telescope of 45 meter diameter, observing at meter wavelength. This statement is correct. This GMRT has a group of 30 steerable parabolic radio telescope and it has a diameter of 45 meter and it is operated by National Center for Radio Astrophysics. And this giant radio telescope is located in Pune, which is in Maharashtra. So first and second one is correct and GMRT has been granted SKA Pathfinder status. What is SKA Pathfinder status? We will see in the next question. But here, third statement is also correct. It has been granted the official status of SKA Pathfinder. So here, all the statements are correct. T is the right answer. And NCRA is a division of the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research. Why this was in news? Because recently, NASA's Chandra X-ray Observatory, Pune-based GMRT, then European Space Agency's XMM Newton and the Murchison Wide Field Array, which is in Western Australia, has detected a giant explosion which occurred in Ophiuchus Galaxy Cluster, which is about 390 million light years away from the Earth. This explosion was around 5 times bigger than any other explosion observed yet. And you have to focus here that this Chandra X-ray, which sounds like an Indian name, is actually a X-ray of NASA, which is a space agency of United States of America. Next question. Consider the following statement about a square kilometer array, that is SKA Pathfinder. So SKA Pathfinder are telescope and systems dotted around the globe. This is correct. So this SKA Pathfinder are group of several telescope which are located in different part of the world. So as GMRT is also granted this status, so it is also one of these several telescopes. And a square kilometer array basically aims to install huge telescopes in South Africa, in Australia, and it also includes other members as well, which one of its member is GMRT. And these are engaged in SKA related technology and science studies. This is also correct. It basically aims to image the sky and study the ongoing phenomena in Milky Way galaxy. So here both these statements are correct. C is the right answer. Next question, Kepler mission was an initiative of. So this mission was an initiative of NASA, the space agency of United States of America. This Kepler mission was specifically designed to survey our regions in Milky Way galaxy to discover hundreds of Earth size and smaller planets in or near the habitable zone. This habitable zone is also known as Goldilocks zone. What is Goldilocks zone? Goldilocks zone are those zones which is neither too hot nor too cold, and these are neither too big nor too small. So Earth lies in a Goldilocks zone. So this mission aimed at finding other planets located in this Goldilocks zone so that lives beyond the Earth can be found. And Kepler Space Telescope was launched in March 2009, and this mission retired in October 2018. But it was in news because recently Colombian researchers have discovered 17 new planets using the data earlier found by NASA's Kepler Space Telescope. Which country has the highest number of billionaires in the world as per the Hurun Global Rich List? This was the previous day question. So it is China. China has the largest number of billionaires, followed by the United States of America. Consider the following statements about steel production in India. India is currently the second largest steel producer or crude steel producer in the world. This is correct. So the largest producer of crude steel is China, and second largest is India, followed by Japan. And Odisha is the highest steel producing state in the country. This is also correct. So remember this state, Odisha. So here C is the right answer. And in India, hematite and magnetite are the most important iron ores, and the chemical formula of hematite is Fe2O3, while the chemical formula of magnetite is Fe3O4. Next question, the Mukundra Tiger Reserve is located in, it is located in Rajasthan, in Kota. It is drained by the tributaries of Chambal River. Chambal River is a very important river flowing in Rajasthan, and the right to protest peacefully is enshrined in which article of the Indian Constitution? So Article 19, Clause 1, Sub Clause A and Sub Clause B provides us the right to protest peacefully. Article 19 is enshrined in Part 3 of the Constitution. Indian Constitution originally had 22 parts, but now after addition of several articles, Indian Constitution has 25 articles, and Indian Constitution has 12 schedules. Originally it had only 8 schedules. And Article 19 provides us 6 fundamental right to freedom. These are freedom of speech and expression, and then freedom to assemble peacefully without arms, then freedom to move anywhere, then freedom to settle anywhere in the country or any part of the country, which applies now in Jammu and Kashmir as well, then freedom to settle anywhere, then freedom to profess or choose any business of your own choice. So these are the 6 fundamental rights provided under this article. Let's see some more facts. Assam Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal was conferred the Dr. Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Award for his work in integrating the nation and to take Mukherjee's vision and philosophy forward. And this Dr. Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Award was instituted by India Foundation. And Dr. Mukherjee was the first Minister of Industry and Supply in independent India. And he co-founded Janata Party, which later was called as Bharatiya Janata Party in the year 1977 to 1979. So if you find the video useful, don't forget to like it, subscribe to the channel and answer the question in the comment section. And wait for the next video. Until then, thanks a lot.